talking with cross country and track and field coach Rod DeHaven. And coach, we have a lot of positive things to discuss in the past couple of weeks. Let's begin with the Summit League Cross Country Championships, the men and women sweeping that not that long ago. What a performance it was in Macomb for your squads.
Yeah, I think certainly for the men, the expectation was to win and maybe not in the same fashion they did in 2019, but certainly with the expectation that they could be, capture a lot of the all-conference places up front. And certainly from an individual standpoint, there was maybe a measure of disappointment in not having an individual winner in the meet, which was the caveat being that you get to go to the NCAA Cross Country Championships. That being said, I thought our men ran a really, really strong race. When you still capture five of the seven first-team all-conference awards and you still get eight guys, being all-conference, pretty strong effort and a testament to the depth and dedication of our young men who, knock on wood, made it through the fall and through the winter without a COVID, sit out and, really have dedicated themselves to being a pretty good squad. So, proud of their effort on that side. I think on the women's side, that was less expected, and I think it was the first time in Summit League history the team's gone 1 through 4 in terms of team places, and their overall team score was the second best ever behind a mark that Southern Utah had put up back in the 90s. So for that group, Leah Hansen, Ellie Friesen, Anna Donne, and Kaylee Peterson, kind of a continuation of what they had done at the Indoor Track and Field Championships, and excited to see that. And Jessica Christopher had a big effort to secure the win, and Bridget Heine also ran a strong race, just kind of stumbled a bit down the stretch, but certainly she early on made us look pretty intimidating when we had those five athletes probably in the top eight for a good majority of the race.
And how about Leah going on to the NCAAs and performing very admirably there as well?
Yeah, again, that the big carrot this year was that making the NCAAs, and I think a little bit of the hard part is when you got four women on your own team, kind of fighting for that individual title. That didn't make that easy but Leah went on and competed very well on a tough day, and some people, 120th, but 120th out of 256, and it's a difficult meet to make in any situation, and there's a lot of great athletes that finished behind her, many that were right in front of her, and great learning experience. To make it a normal year, there's obviously probably a little bit of a step up that she'll need to take, because the Midwest region has gotten stronger, and as evidenced by some of the team finishes that our region had the national meet. But I think she'll be up to the challenge, as potentially some of our other women will be next fall as well.
And to your point about Leah's finish too, I mean, that's one of the better ones in Summit League history. It's one of the top 10 ever, right?
Yeah, but I think it shows how hard it is to get to the stinking meet. I mean, you've got, one female All-American all-time and, another one that's finished in the 60s. And then, typically an individual qualifier that comes out doesn't make the top 100. And, Oklahoma State did a great job of hosting under unique circumstances, and their course proved to be, one of the more formidable ones that we've had out there in a long time.
Well, that's cross country, but there also were the NCAA Indoor Track and Field Championships this past weekend, and Trent Francom had a tremendous performance for you, being able to get there and what he turned in.
Right, yeah, Trent, great story coming back, from the pandemic and, literally creating his own facility to continue to hone his vaulting skills. Makes that first bar at 17.4 and a half, and then, gets a little tight. At the next bar, certainly he's capable of making that bar and probably at least another one after that. But, getting there was obviously a big accomplishment, finishing 10th in the country. Not exactly what he wanted, definitely wanted to be one of those top eight and first team All-American. But, a good learning experience, and I think if he can continue to relax and be consistent, he'll be a force, in Division I pole vaulting. And, it was a culmination of really a great, track season. Looking back at the Summit League Indoor Championships, we really felt our men and women, overperformed in terms of what we were projected to score in terms of points. The men probably moved up a spot, passing USD with their performance, and the women, I think that's our highest point total in a long time. And just really a lot of people that stepped up and showed up on a weekend that, again, a little bit different without, you know, fans in the building, but they did a great job, and looking forward to the outdoor season.
When you talk about what cross country did, we just went through obviously indoor track and field, to have done all this amid this pandemic, all the challenges that they had, you must be extremely proud of your student athletes.
Yeah, I am, you know, because I think it weighed on different people in different ways, you know, and you know, whether it was going back to last spring or if it was even winter break, which was pretty extended, you know, for you know, our group, you know, leaving campus, you know, in some cases, you know, it was middle of November and not coming back until January 10th and not having, you know, maybe the best opportunities to train during that time period. Most of them did a great job of doing their very best to try and get themselves back into, you know, the best version of themselves that they could possibly be. And that's, we can't ask for much more than that, you know, in this year. And now, you know, we hope that we can have a quasi-normal outdoor season. You know, obviously it'll be a little bit different with probably more regional stuff than what we've had in the past, but still, you know, that opportunity to compete, and then particularly those seniors, super seniors that didn't compete last spring that we'll bring back, I think, you know, they're kind of like caged animals a little bit, and looking forward to getting out and about here, you know, very soon.
Let's end on that then. What does the outdoor season look like for your program?
Well, it's still probably a work in progress. I think, you know, we're looking at, you know, different meets, and, you know, certainly because of, you know, there are still some restrictions in terms of size of meets, and typically outdoor meets can turn into these big human festivals of, you know, 2,000-3,000 people. And, you know, I think most people are kind of saying, okay, that's not going to necessarily be probably the best choice at this point. So, you know, we'll do some meets at USD, and we're trying to fill in some of the, you know, the blanks in some of the other areas. You know, Howard Wood Dakota Relays is not on the circuit for us this year. It's a choice that kind of limited that to a high school situation. So we're searching for some different things, and certainly, you know, those athletes that we feel that have that chance to make the first round of the NCAAs, you know, they're going to get probably some opportunities that won't be so regional because of either competition or weather, whatever we need to find to make sure that they, you know, get those chances. So we'll get it all ironed out, but yeah, it's again exciting to be thinking that we're going to have an opportunity to compete this spring is really a positive thing for our program.